So shiftless and lazy. Get up! Come on! Mama. Looky here. A general done dug himself a hole. Just like a rat. You think you're gonna escape like those others? Well, think again, scum. You're going down in a hole, all right, but it's gonna be 6 feet deep. Now, chain him up. Come on. Till I decide how we're gonna stop him from digging rat holes. I got kegs of gunpowder hidden underneath this floor. Very next man that tries to escape, I'm gonna blow you all to hell.
Merry Christmas. A little early, but what the hell? Had a 3-day leave, heard you in Richmond. So where are we having dinner tonight?
We got a lot to catch up on. That's it.
Sure is great to see you alive, Warrior. I didn't want to believe it when I saw you listed as missing.
I landed in a field hospital. I was lucky.
Your friend George wasn't so lucky.
What do you mean?
Mosby rode into camp the other day. Report on his guerrilla activities. I heard him tell Hampton that he had captured a Yankee general in one of his raids. Turns out it was George.
Where is he?
Libby prison.
He could die there. That place is a disgrace.
Well, there's nothing you can do. No more prisoner exchanges, so you can't go to Davis. Besides, he's the enemy.
What? Charles. That man was my best friend. What's wrong with you?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? I am going to get him out of there, and you're going to help me.
I don't feel too kindly about Yankees these days.
None of us do, but I owe him.
Up to you, General.
Well, you can't see General Weather. He's gone on leave.
You'll address me as Sir, Corporal, and you'll tell me who's in charge in the General's absence.
Yes, sir. Captain Turner's in charge right now, sir. But he's, well, he ain't here right now, neither.
If he's derelict in his duty, he will suffer the consequences. In the meantime, you're to deliver to me a prisoner by the name of General George Hazard.
But it's the middle of the night, sir, and Captain Turner, he wouldn't like it. He wouldn't like it
like... I don't give a damn what Captain Turner wouldn't like. I've got orders to take this prisoner for interrogation, and that's what I mean to do, Corporal. You have him brought here to me now.
Yes, sir.
This man's condition is an outrage. Get his chains off of him. Now! I I intend to report this entire detachment for gross neglect of duty.
What the hell is going on here?
They got orders to take him, Captain.
Oh, my dead body. Whose orders?
I would suggest you read this as snap two, Captain, before I have you relieved of command.
I never heard of no General Canby. And I want this order confirmed before I hand over the prisoner.
You don't have the authority, Captain, so out of our way, we're leaving.
I already told you it's over my dead body.
Longer in there, Ori. You saved my life. Thank you. Both of you.
Just don't get yourself shot on the way home.
Okay. You got food? A blanket, some of my old clothes? Follow the current as far as you can, and then head north. You're bound to run into some Union troops.
Will you do me another favor?
What's that?
Tell Jeff Davis that if he stops the war, I'll buy the champagne.
You best make that offer to Mr. Lincoln.
Be light soon. Let's go. I'm not sure we lost the guards.
Be all right.
We'll kill Yankees by the hundreds and save one man. Does it make any sense?
Compassion still makes sense.
Round your And you know what? You've been so good that I think you can open another present before you go to bed. Well, why don't you sit here?
Stanley, they're beautiful. What a surprise. Mother. Aren't they magnificent?
They're lovely, Isabel.
Constance.
Very pretty.
I shall wear these in Philadelphia on New Year's Eve. Thank you, my darling.
I should have waited and given it to you in private.
Nonsense. I'm not going to let their moods ruin this special evening. We have every right to enjoy our good fortune.
Mother, are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine.
It's lovely to see Hope enjoying herself. I just keep thinking of Billy and George. It doesn't seem like Christmas without them.
No, it doesn't. You know, sometimes I wonder if I'll be able to survive another day without George. Oh, but Mother, think how difficult it must be for those families whose loved ones will never be coming home.
I can't believe Clarissa is in the midst of that fighting. Every night I pray for the Maines just as I pray for our family. How can we sing about peace on earth, goodwill toward men after 4 years of war? Dear God, how much longer must this go on?
If General Grant takes Petersburg, it might be over before we know it.
Mrs. Hazard to you.
Heard about your trouble, so I thought I'd come over and see if I could help out. Things seem to be a little lean around here.
We're doing just fine.
That's no way to talk to the man who could be your salvation. I got food.
We have enough.
Figured you for the sensible. Surely you know what a dangerous situation you all are in. Three women alone. But if we could come to some arrangement, well, I can make sure that nobody will bother you. Not even the Yankees, who I figure will be harder on South Carolina, seeing as we started the war.
You're nothing but trash like those squatters. We're not leaving, no matter what you do or say.
Shake the tree and all the fruit you could want will fall right in your lap. Time's on my side, Missy.
Get on out of here, Salem Jones, or this other barrel's gonna blow your head off.
You wouldn't do that, Semiramis.
Wouldn't I? I've hated you ever since I was a little girl. Now get on out of here! Leave the horse.
Thank you.
I could head straight for Richmond or turn back and attack Lee at his flank.
Even if General Fitz-Lee could concentrate all three of his brigades, I'm not sure he could stop them either way.
We can jump a couple of their flank scouts and find out where they're headed.
Charlie, I hadn't been on my own feet 2 hours in the last 3 days. So nag of mine is wind broke as I am. How in the heck are we gonna stop them?
That's too bad. Yeah.
The Lord isn't a rebel.
I don't get carried away. We need at least one of them alive.
All right.
Aim for the legs.
Sorry, Captain. Reckon my aim was high.
Sure, it's cavalry, right? Don't have much of a choice. Now, we got miles to go to reach your point. I estimate 2 divisions, maybe 3. Which is it?
3.
Found where? Bad enough you Yankees burned beaver dam stakes in that supply warehouse.
Don't try my patience.
Found where?
Where? Richmond!
He was just reaching over because he was thirsty.
He had been pulling a gun. Better my mistake than me dead.
Charlie, you really are something. Cool as a block in an ice house. You're some kind of killing machine. The absolute sure fired best.
We gotta find Fitz Lee. You take the turnpike, I'll go across country. One of us is sure to get through.
I don't suppose it's quite so merry in Savannah with Sherman.
He'll be marching into Charleston next.
Some of the women are leaving town.
Well, what brings you out this way so early?
Just my usual desire to look at your pretty face and to bring you this.
It's very kind.
Now, you can take it. Feel no obligation. It's really not for you. It's for them. Earned with the sweat of my brow. I just wasted anyway, and I figured you could use it for whatever purpose.
The soldiers picked up Michael and some of the other boys.
Where did they take them?
I don't know. They said it was needed. Too many soldiers getting killed.
We have to find them. They're only children.
How long ago?
Oh, about 2 hours. Miss Madeline, I'm so scared.
Don't worry about it. We'll do our best to get them back. Found out where they've been taken.
Where?
Don't worry about it right now. I want you to go home and wait for me there.
Ray, I would like to help.
You can't. Just do like I tell you. It may already be too late.
Oh, look alive! Look alive!
Well, I bet you wish you was back on that plantation, don't you, huh?
Come on, Deepa.
Come on, move that dirt, darkies. Come on, look alive there.
Don't take that tree out.
Look sharp, bad boy. I'm gonna throw your carcass to Sherman.
Maybe your carcass, Sergeant.
Just you and you, huh?
These are your orders from your captain to take these boys back to my plantation.
Your plantation?
Food is the lifeline of the Confederacy, Sergeant.
You too, over here.
Now we've got to feed Johnston's troops if we expect him to stop Sherman.
Well, just who's gonna finish digging these here rifle pits, huh?
Neither you nor your men look very helpless to me, Sergeant.
Hey, that ain't no kind of work for white men.
You read your orders and do your duty.
My duty is to get my share. See, I know all about your Captain Farley and his little payoffs. So, you see this here order? It ain't worth the paper it's written on.
You get the boys in the wagon, and I'll see that you're taken care of, Sergeant.
All
you boys, in this here
blasted wagon. Be quick about it. Come on, move it. I only pay once.
Captain Farley wanted cold, hard cash, and a lot of it, I'm afraid.
You bribed an officer?
Well, I had no choice.
If you had been arrested, we'd all have been in jeopardy.
Well, should I have done something more honorable? You've got to wake up, Madeline. Honor's dead. It's been killed in the war. Now on their only transactions.
For you, that's the way you live.
That's right, ma'am. To survive.
Well, some things are more important than survival.
Like what, Madeline? I left the army rather than go on killing innocent human beings in a cause already doomed from the start by the stupidity of too many of its leaders.
I don't want to hear that.
I refuse to be a fool. I found a better way of attacking a Yankee position, and when I returned, I was accused by my commander of insubordination. Now, if that makes me some kind of a scoundrel, then so be it.
I didn't mean to. You saved Michael's life, and I thank you for that.
Madeline, there's so much I want to tell you.
It's late.
You'd never touch any of Justin's money. Now, if you're prepared to do that, at least make life more comfortable for you and your child. Don't keep
it. If the money is mine, then I am entitled to spend it as I see fit. Uncle Miles, Justin never did one good thing for anyone in his entire life. So let's just call this poetic justice.
And when his money is gone, then I'll sell the house.
I'm not even sure I could find a buyer right now, let alone get a good price.
Well, even if I have to sell the house at a loss, there should still be enough to help a great many people.
Now, I understand you're wanting to help these people that have been displaced by the war, but you can't bankrupt yourself to do it. And what about your son, Madeline? That house should be his someday.
Thousands have been driven from their homes. Slaves, freed Negroes, poor whites, they have no food, no money, they have no hope. I can't just stand by and watch women and children die. I hope my son will understand that one day when he's old enough.
You're giving away everything you have.
I would give more if I had it. Uncle Miles, you can't imagine the suffering.
All right, my dear. It's obvious you're going to do this whether I agree or not. Justice money isn't sufficient. I'll find a way to sell the house.
Thank you, Uncle Miles. Thank you. I knew you'd understand. I have a surprise for you.
What? Oh, I love surprises.
I know you do. Open it up.
Well, this looks familiar.
I had the tailor repair it. I want my husband going back on duty looking like the general he is.
Oh, thank you. That's very sweet. And as it just so happens, I have a little gift for you, too.
Do? Huh? Oh, George, it's beautiful.
Do you like it?
I love it.
I had Stanley pick it up for me in Philadelphia on his last trip there.
Oh, thank you. You know, it's been so wonderful having you home these past few weeks. I hate to think of you leaving again so soon.
I don't think that Grant will let this deadlock drag on much longer. It's got to end soon. But I am afraid that Lee will fight on to the bitter end, along with all his men.
I know. You're worried about Ari again, aren't you?
Yes. Our little reunion while out on patrol a couple of years ago wasn't as pleasant as I might have led you to believe.
What do you mean?
Well, at first it was like nothing had changed. It was just so good to see him again. But it became obvious to me that the war had done something to that sense of understanding that we always seemed to share. By the time we said goodbye, we were acting just like enemies.
Ah, George.
And when he broke me out of prison, it was more like he was repaying an old debt instead of an act of friendship.
Darling, I love Ari as much as you do. And I know the kind of man he is. He would never turn his back on you or your friendship. Captain Bradley.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm Constance Hazard. The maid told me you're here to see my husband.
I'm on General Hazard's staff, ma'am. I have some rather urgent business with him.
I see. Well, why don't you wait in the library and I'll get him for you.
This isn't an official visit, General, but I wanted to warn you ahead of time. rather discuss this in private, sir.
Unless it involves military secrets, Captain, I have nothing I want to hide from my wife.
Sir, from what I've been able to find out, the War Department has had complaints for almost 2 years about defective weapons made by Axel Ironworks. Do you know anything about such a company?
No, I've never heard of them.
A formal investigation wasn't started until recently, and they found that Axel Iron is a front for another arms manufacturer, Hazard Iron.
Well, but that's ridiculous. George would never have anything to do with something like that.
They verified that these cannons were made from cheap metals, which caused some of them to explode after prolonged use. I'm afraid some soldiers on the gun crews have been killed as a result.
Oh, my God.
But everybody knows that while George was away, his brother Stanley was running the company.
Apparently, the general signature appears on several incriminating documents which connect the two companies.
Well, then someone forged his signature.
And it had to be somebody from the inside.
Unfortunately, you're going to have to prove that, sir.
I don't believe this. My husband risked his life and endured great hardship in prison. How can his own government accuse him of such a crime?
Ma'am, I feel the same way, or I wouldn't be here. But I'm afraid all the evidence seems to be against you, General.
Captain, you said this was an unofficial visit. How much time do I have to prove my innocence?
I'm afraid they'll be swearing out a warrant for your arrest within the next few hours.
Well, can't you delay it?
I wish I could. I just found out this morning.
What else can you tell us, Captain?
There seems to be a man named Morgan. Although there's no solid evidence against him, they suspect that he's involved in selling cheap metals to more than one foundry.
Do you know where I can find him?
He does most of his business out of a tavern outside Philadelphia called Dillard's.
Which one's Morgan?
Morgan? Who are you?
Never you mind. Just point him out to me. You Morgan?
And if I am?
I'd like some straight answers. You have a business arrangement with Hazard Iron?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You've been selling inferior metals through a dummy company.
You can't prove anything.
I want to know who your contact is.
Who the hell are you?
My name is George Hazard, you miserable scum. A lot of good men have died because of you. You're coming with me to the War Department. You're going to tell them everything you know, and you're going to spend the rest of your life in prison.
Along with you and your brother, General Hazard.
I just talked to Morgan, and he connected you with Axel Iron. I don't want to believe this, Stanley.
George.
Just tell me it isn't true.
You're my brother. I have trusted you with everything. How could you do this?
Stanley, don't tell him anything.
Don't you realize what you've done? There's been a government investigation and they're going to arrest George.
Whatever trouble he's in, it's his own doing.
Enough!
Isabel, I have always given you everything you've ever wanted. Now, I will not sacrifice my brother. George, I had no idea any of this would ever happen with those cannons. And when I found out it was too late, our whole business was at stake. Our future...
What about our future, Stanley? You have not only befouled this family's reputation, you have probably destroyed the future of Hazard Iron, which is nothing compared to the senseless killing of who knows how many Union soldiers.
What?
You miserable traitor!
Please forgive me.
You must take full responsibility, as will this company, to the families of those dead soldiers. Undoubtedly, that means long prison terms for both you and Isabel.
I've done nothing illegal. My signature was not on those documents.
Apparently, you haven't heard your husband, dear. It's over, Isabel.
If you can find the courage to own up to your actions, you might find some self-respect.
Unusually impatient today, Ashton.
I told you those things take time, and they take money. You have a definite lack of the latter.
But I've already given you all of mine.
There is someone who has just promised an enormous contribution, but I'm afraid he wants something more in return other than mere participation in our new government.
What does he want?
Thomas Drummond has always had his eye on you.
That old fool? Every time he sees me, looks down my dress and drools.
Exactly.
You can't mean it. That is the most ridiculous thing I ever heard.
What's so ridiculous? All you have to do is spend one night with him. And $15,000 in gold is ours.
You can't mean that.
Of course I do. He knows that you and I are friends.
Friends? We love each other.
I don't recall mentioning love. Love would be the worst possible thing for us. We're equals. We are partners. Love would just get in the way of everything we want.
But as I was saying before I was interrupted, we love each other's strength and power.
So then you'll do it.
Why wouldn't I? After all, it only makes us that much closer to what we want.
I knew I could count on you.
I had no idea you thought me attractive, Mr. Drummond. Otherwise, I would have come here long before this.
You do me an honor, Miss Ashton.
On the contrary, sir. You do me and our cause the honor. Donation, sir, was so generous, but I felt that I had to repay you the only way I know how.
It's all right, Ashton.
Are you right, James?
Expect to celebrate here, do you?
Couldn't think of a more appropriate place.
Well, everybody says it's unsafe to leave the city, Al.
Now, where is your spirit of adventure, Ashton?
Come on, get down.
I'm tired of playing games, Al. What is it you want to show me?
Now, you just be patient.
Guns.
Along with my military expertise, I have developed quite a flair for raising money. Now, this was all bought with cash donated by supporters of our cause.
Like Drummond?
Exactly. Men whose ambition exceeds their intelligence. I still need another shipment, so I've arranged for this with a profiteer down in South Carolina. Gets his guns from a man in Barbados. I will be leaving for Charleston tomorrow.
How long will you be gone?
You won't have too long to pine for me. We have to move against Mr. Davis in 2 weeks or so. Otherwise, it'll be too late. I just want to make sure that we kill Mr. Davis and every one of his loyal followers.
Including my brother.
Especially your brother. I haven't forgotten the injuries to which I owe Mr. Maine. We're gonna have a little time for us.
Not here.
Yeah, here, right now.
Never ends, does it, Miss Burton?
It seems to be 3 times the amount of people we started with.
How are you going to keep this up, ma'am? You can't feed everybody who's hungry in the whole South.
I'll do what I can for as long as I can.
Food costs the way it does. I don't see how we're going to keep this up much longer.
Excuse me, ma'am. Now, look, I know that you must nearly be out of cash by now. You've been feeding these people for months. And you've also got a little baby to think of. Now, I have a little money and some very good connections in town. I could help you get more food and medicines, maybe some men to drive you instead of the boy.
In exchange for what?
Well, now, that's entirely up to you.
Well, I appreciate your help, Mr. Bodine. I really do. But that's as far as it goes. You can find food or medicine. Please bring it to the camp.
Yes, ma'am.
Why don't you leave?
I must confess, I never expect to find a buyer for your house so soon.
They certainly offered a fair price.
Under the circumstances, more than generous. However, there was one term the buyer insisted upon that I couldn't accept without your consent.
My consent?
Well, he insists that the sale be anonymous.
Well, is there anything wrong with that?
No, not wrong.
Then sell it. I need the money.
Then you may consider the sale closed, my dear.
The war has certainly taken its toll. The supplies we received only yesterday have almost gone. Nice. Goodbye.
Bodine. Good Lord, man, I told you to stay away from here today.
Well, I've been avoiding danger much too long to be caught by an unsuspecting woman. Did she accept?
Of course. She's all obsessed with this refugee work of hers.
Well, now she'll have the means to continue it.
Until it ruins her, I'm afraid.
And a woman like her can never be ruined, Mr. Colbert. And in the end, I'll see to it she gets her house back. I really don't want a damn thing.
Well, why didn't you just give her the money, then?
Because she'd never take it from me. Even though it does come out of the pockets of some of Charleston's most respected families.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Wait, surely not stolen?
Oh, no. It's earned quite honestly right down at the Stars and Bars Inn.
She knew the money came from gambling.
But she never will. You'll have the money tomorrow. So congratulate yourself, Mr. Colbert. It's not every day that a lawyer helps a scoundrel help a lady.
I realize, Mr. Bent, that you and your mercenaries need these guns. But that price I quoted you was last month, before the misfortunes of our Confederacy caused a further downward plunge in the value of paper money.
You cannot just double the price. A deal, sir, is a deal.
I suggest you keep your voice down, sir. Some patriotic fools are so upset about the Yankee occupation that they might be inclined to stretch our necks if they knew what nefarious business we were about to conclude.
Now, you're just going to have to accept my offer as is, because that's all I brought with me.
You're fortunate, Mr. Bent, that my contact at the Barbados is willing to accept 10% in gold. I would suggest that you close this deal before the price of a loaf of bread goes to $100, rifles to $1,000 each. I would say you have 24 hours before the price goes up again.
How am I supposed to raise that kind of cash here with all the Yankees snooping around Charleston?
A clever man such as yourself should be able to think of something. You have a way with the ladies. Why don't you charm our local heiress, Mrs. Picard?
Heiress?
Someone must have left her a fortune. She's been feeding every white trash and refugee and ex-slave for miles around. They call her the Angel Lady.
Well, then perhaps this angel might be persuaded to be generous to my cause as well.
I have heard she's desperate for food for her camp.
Where might I find this paragon of generosity?
Apparently, she lives in a seedy boarding house near here, something consistent with her eccentricities.
There's barely a handful of cornmeal left for each child, and there's no milk at all.
Done everything you can, Madeline. You can't create food if there isn't it.
I still have money left from the sale of the house, but there's nothing to buy with it. I've tried everywhere.
Listen, Sherman is already marching north to try and trap Johnston and Lee. Between himself and Grant, it should all be over very soon now.
Will it, Rafe? Or will things just be worse when the war is over?
I don't know. I just know that I can't stand to see you like this.
Madeline, I love you. I've never said that to anyone before in my life, but it's true.
Please don't.
Why? I know you at least care for me.
I do. But I can't let it be anything more than that.
You can't or you won't.
You almost guessed the truth once before. I'm not a widow. My husband is still living.
Do you still love him?
Please don't ask me any more questions. Just believe me, I can never be what you want me to be.
We should be together. You feel the same way.
No! A part of me would always belong to him. You'd come to hate me for it.
Madeline,
I'd only end up hurting you. I couldn't live with myself if I did. I'm sorry, Rafe. Please take me home.
Bodine, how nice to see you again.
Miss Hope.
This is Picard. Another gentleman called while you were away. He left his card. Said he'd be at the Mills house.
Do you know the man?
What? I know. Someone I once knew did.
He seemed like a real gentleman. He said he could call whenever it was convenient. The sooner the better were his exact words. If you'd like for me to send a message, I'd be
I appreciate your interest. But I'll take care of it. Thank you again, Mrs. Sharp.
Would you like me to find out what this gentleman wants?
No, that won't be necessary. Thank you for escorting me home.
And for your kindness. Good day, sir.
It will be a good day, ma'am, when you change your mind about us. I won't give up.
Miss Sinclair.
My stage name. It's Mrs. Westcott now.
I need to speak to you. It's very important.
Come here.
I saw you play Cordelia in King Lear. I was 17, but I've never forgot it. You couldn't have been more than 17 yourself.
I wasn't. Surprised that you remembered me. Thank you. It's been a very long time since anyone's mentioned my acting. I gave it up years ago when I married.
Is that your husband?
Yes. Robert was killed at Gettysburg.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
What was it you wanted to talk to me about, Mrs. Picard?
I would like to hire you as an actress.
Who would want him out of theatrical production now with Charleston occupied?
Well, it's not a play exactly. Your services would only be required for one evening, and I will pay you what I can afford.
Do you want me to break the law in some way?
Oh, no. No. I need to find out why someone wants to see me. But I must warn you, there is a risk involved. I will provide you with all the protection I can. But if you're the actress I believe you are, you won't need it.
You intrigue me, Mrs. Picard. And I haven't been intrigued by anything since my husband died. What part do you want me to play?
Me.
Wait here.
You're to wait in here, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Bent?
Mrs. Picard.
Please, sit down.
Thank you. I've always been fascinated by women who wear veils.
especially when the face behind the veil is as beautiful as yours is, Mrs. Picard.
You flatter me, sir. A woman in my position needs to be careful about revealing herself.
Great wealth must be handled with great care. I understand that you need more food for your refugees.
That is correct.
I think I can help you in that regard. But that is just one of the reasons that I wanted to meet you.
Oh.
A woman such as yourself, who is doing so much to help the poor women and children of Charleston, is demonstrating a rare kind of patriotism.
Thank you for the compliment, but I'm not sure.
You could help even more. A very small part of your fortune could ensure the well-being and safety of every refugee in the South.
How is that, Mr. Bent?
By helping me put the government into the hands of someone who can win the war.
Go on.
If the South is destroyed, all your efforts to help the poor would be crushed as well. Now, a woman of your obvious intelligence must see that the disastrous policies of Jefferson Davis have put the Confederacy in the perilous position it is in today. The Yankees in Charleston and the Yankees at the gates of Richmond.
It is tragic.
If, on the other hand, we were led by a man of political and military brilliance who also had an iron will, we could still force the Union to its knees.
I never thought of it like that. But of course, you're right.
Mrs. Picard, you could be a great inspiration for a great revolution that I'm more than ready to lead.
I'd like to think about what you've told me for a day or two. It's all so overwhelming.
I have a large company of dedicated men waiting in the wings. We are short of supplies. Time is of the essence. I don't think I can wait that long for an answer. Tomorrow morning at the latest.
I'll see that you get one. Quickly.
Thank you. I have the feeling that we have met somewhere before.
Impossible, sir. I'd certainly remember a man like you.
Well, then I'll call on you again tomorrow morning for your answer.
Appalling man. I'm sure he'd actually leave.
I'm sorry you had to go through that, but I was afraid he might recognize me. I have reason to believe he knows what I look like.
He almost seemed to recognize me. What if he seen me on the stage?
It's too dangerous. You can't see him again.
The way he talked, he intends on overthrowing President Davis.
And he wants you to finance it.
Oh, he was right. Elkanah Bent has to be stopped. I'm going to try to hire a rider to take a message to Richmond. Your fee.
Oh, use the money for your children. Think of it as a benefit performance.
Thank you. Your Robert would have been very proud of you tonight.
Why'd you hire that actress to meet me? She was a lovely Juliet once, but I didn't quite believe her in the role of Mrs. Picard. well ever fit the role perfectly. Mrs. Picard! I'm not gonna let you go till I've seen your face and know why you've been trying to hide it from me. Now, let's see what's under your veil.
Did the bleeding stop?
Oh, good. These herbs are gonna heal it.
Ezra? Drink this, it's gonna help.
Thank you, Miss Britt. Sorry about what happened. Tomorrow I start on a new wheel. Oh,
don't you worry about that. You need another pair of hands?
I could use him, Sammy.
Well, seems like you're gonna be all right, Ezra. I thought he was the handsomest man that ever lived. I still do. This was the gown I wore when we met. It was an April cotillion. May I have the pleasure of the next dance, Miss Clarissa? I didn't hesitate a bit. And before I knew it, I was in his arms. Oh, Mama. After we danced, he bowed to me and said I looked as young and lovely as a spring morning. Your father wasn't always that sentimental. But the way he said it came right from his heart. Oh, Dylan. What happened to all our dreams? You made us all feel so safe. Oh, Brett. Mama. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Where you going, Jimmy?
Home, Major. It's over.
No, it's not! You're deserting!
We're beat, Charlie. Can't you see that? Grant's got us bottled up at Petersburg, and he's gonna stomp us until there's more blood in the trenches than rainwater. You know, Richmond can't hold out much longer. There's no more need in dying. I'm sick of it. I can't take no more. I slept in the mud for 4 years. I've eaten slop day after day. I don't know if my wife and children are alive or dead. So I'm going home, Major. You can shoot me if you want to. I'd rather die than keep on this way. You've changed, Charlie. If I was you, I'd take a real hard look at myself before I started in on the rest of it.
Been so long.
How are you, Washington?
I've been better, Captain Charles.
Where's Boss?
A few weeks ago, I was visiting neighbors who had a sick child. While I was gone, a party of Union soldiers came by. Boz wouldn't let them have my mare and colt, so they shot him.
I was down by the river when I heard the shot. When I got back, they were riding away. My boy was... The It's my fault, Miss Augusta. I startled him. I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine. Sorry, sir. Hope I didn't burn you none.
I'm sorry, Wash.
Yes.
Last thing I wanted to do was to hurt his feelings. I'm not fit to be around decent people.
It's not you. It's the war.
I don't know when I can see you again. Don't.
Why did you come back here?
I don't know. Nothing makes any sense anymore.
Let me help you.
It's too late.
I appreciate what you've done, Mr. Antoon, especially on your own. We've had our differences, but we're both loyal to the same cause. Oh, all right, so good to see you again.
Mr. President.
I believe you know Mr. Antoon. He's brought me some extraordinary information about illegal guns, and well, I felt that you would know best how to deal with it.
What the hell are you doing here? You are interfering with a meeting of crucial significance to our future. Now you just get out of here.
I have to talk to you.
I do not care if you have to talk to me right now. You are acting with blatant disregard to our plans.
Listen to me, Elle. It's too dangerous. We could lose everything. Why don't we sell this to a profiteer and get out now before it's too late?
You're starting to sound just like your husband. It is not too late.
Everybody knows that the Confederacy is dead!
The Confederacy will flourish under my presidency. After we have destroyed the enemy. All my enemies!
Elkanah!
Get out of here right now.
I have every right to be here.
Don't you dare disobey me.
And don't you dare talk to me like I'm one of your lackeys!
Now, you can't leave.
I'll hide in the back.
And you stay there. You keep your mouth shut.
Had a devil of a time finding the place.
So would somebody else,
I hope.
I'm sure you can understand the absolute necessity for secrecy.
Dear God, where did you get all this?
I do have a number of prominent backers, sir.
You've got enough weapons here for a regiment.
James. It's time for us to make history. Together. Are we going to chop the head of the snake right off? And we are going to make sure that the cut is clean. Now, in order to do that, we need more guns. We need more ammunition. We need your help, sir.
You said there'd be no violence.
Now, you listen to me. In order to assure the absolute security of our new government, we have got to kill Jefferson Davis.
You'd really do that?
Any and every officer who refuses to pledge their allegiance to me or to you will be executed, starting with Brigadier General Aura Main.
You're the one that's gonna die, Ben.
Main. You set me up, didn't you?
I may be a fool, Bent, but I am not a killer, nor a traitor. Someone had to stop you.
You stopped me? You couldn't even stop your wife from sleeping with me. My life with this man, ever since West Point. Every time you meddled in my affairs, every time you injured me, I always knew I'd have this moment when you'd be at my mercy.
Empire.
It was like Judgment Day. Like it says in the Bible, all sinners shall burn in everlasting fire. I'm a sinner too. I'm gonna burn in hell with you, Elkanah.
Stop it, Ashton. Nothing happened to you.
But it will. I've done terrible things. I tried to have Billy killed. Then I got rid of a baby before I got married. Madeline.
What did you do to her? What did you do to her? Ashton, you tell me, or I will kill you now.
I didn't hurt her. I made her go away from Mount Royal.
Made her go away? How?
Elkanah. He had a picture of her mother. She was a black whore in New Orleans. And when I told her the mother would die if anyone found out.
Damn you, Ashton! Where is she? Where is she?
No.
Get away from me. Get out of my sight. Get her out of my sight! I don't ever want to see her again. Get away from me!
Look in the gate.
It's too late, Ashton. Too late.
Get away from me!